السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أيوة. Mean people to wake up. تركي. إلى أين؟ ها؟ قل إلى تركي إلى أين؟ وبعد السؤال خطير. أنا وبيني وأنا وتركي قصة هو عارف. أقول له من إيش اسمك؟ يقول لي تركي. اسمك تركي. الله المستعان. Anyway. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن شاء الله we'll continue with the... نبدأ بألفية السيرة إن شاء الله. قلنا وليعلم فين وليعلم الطالب أن السيرة تجمع ما صح وما قد أنكر. طبعا نحن عندنا السيرة سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم بدأنا فيها الأسبوع الماضي وذكرنا بعض أسماء النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. نذكرها إن شاء الله سريعا حتى نحن نعيدها إن شاء الله for review. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم مع المقفى أو المقفي أحمد الحاشر العاقب الماحي الردى وهو المسمى بنبي الرحمة في مسلم وبنبي التوبة. قلنا أن من أسماء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لابد أن نفهم أنه في فرق بين الاسم والإيه والصفة. There is a difference between the name and the attribute of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the Sheikh حفظه الله رحمه الله he mentioned both together. So we would tell you which one is the name, which one is the description, inshallah, or an attribute of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad is the name of Rasulullah sallallahu Ahmad is the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Muqaffa, the one whom people follow. Al-Hashir, the one whom people will be resurrected after him. هذا كله أخذناه. Al-Aqib, الماحي الردى, the one who clarify and clear and purify the religion from shirk and kufr. الماحي is the one who erase something. والردى هو الكفر. قلنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما أرسله الله عز وجل كان ماحيا للشرك والكفر. فبعد النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا يقول إنسان آمن بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وآمن بالله عز وجل إلا لا إله إلا الله لا معبود بحق إلا الله من غير شريك without a partner without associating someone with Allah سبحانه وتعالى وهو المسمى بنبي الرحمة the prophet of mercy في مسلم in the narration of Muslim وبنبي التوبة وفيه أيضا بنبي الملحمة is the prophet of war وفيه نبي المرحمة also the prophet of mercy طه وياسين مع الرسول نطاها It's not some علماء considered to be a name of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقلنا أن هذا الصحيح أن طه وياسين ما هما حروف مقطعة من بداية السور تمام It's not the names of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم It's the letters that the Quran starts with طه ياسين بس لكن هل هو من أسماء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هنا الشيخ العراقي رحمه الله mentioned to be a name of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم The truth is, as we said, it's not part of his name. It's not part of the names of Rasul. مع الرسول is the prophet. كذاك عبد الله في التنزيلي that his name is Abdullah, the slave of Allah. And Allah mentioned him that in the Quran. والمتوكل the one who depends on Allah, he relies on Allah. النبي الأمي cannot write and read. الرؤوف الرحيم أي رحمي. He is the most merciful, the peaceful man among all of human beings. شاهدا مبشرا نذيرا كذا سراجا صل به منيرا شاهد is the one who witness نحن we will witness in the day of judgment and then رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يكون علينا شاهد and he will witness so witness for other nations and then رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يشهد علينا يوم القيامة ويشهد لنا يوم القيامة مبشرا the one who give glad tidings نذيرا is the one who warn people from something and he warns people from hellfire and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كذا سراجا صل به منيرا من أسماء أو من صفات النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم هو السراج المنير السراج هو المصباح والمنير يعني عظيم الإنارة Siraj is the light. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah described him as in the Quran to be Siraj for us, to be light for us. He's our guidance in dunya and in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Nur, light. But he's not made from light. You have to understand that. The human beings are made from clay. The malaika are made from light. The jinn are made, or the shayateen are made from the flame of fire. Okay? لذلك بعض الناس يقول أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he's actually نور. He's actually a light. That he's created like the angels. نقول هذا غير صحيح. وأن الله سبحانه يقول سراجا منيرا, that he lights the way for you. وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا رؤي كأنه فلقة قمر. If someone would see Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم as if you see the moon in the 15th of the month. How bright is the moon in the 15th of the month? Full. You could see it very clearly. It has a lot of light. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما يقول أنس لما دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة أنار منها كل شيء. ولما مات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجعت كما كانت. أنس رضي الله عنه said when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم entered مدينة everything in مدينة seemed to have light. When Rasulullah entered, when he was migrating and he entered Medina, everything as if whole Medina had no light, then out of a sudden, Medina had light. A lot of light in everywhere in Medina. And then he said, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, as if Medina went back to what it was before him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he's actually light, ay annahu eh? Huh? He lights the way for us. He show us the way. You know the... Subhanallah, without light, see how the old people used to study, how the old people used to do work. Halas, maybe 5 p.m. before sunset, everybody will stop. They can't, or else they'll fire some wood or something to create that light that we need now, alhamdulillah. That light, when you study and the light cut off or something happened, then you're stuck. You have to go to the library, you have to get some light. Subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was light for us, that he led the way to paradise. Or else the way was dark. كان ظلماتهم بعضها فوق بعض. People not only worshipped idols, لكن they knew that it wasn't true. And other people start worshipping other things. And then they start innovating new things to worship. عمر رضي الله عنه كان يقول كنا والله قبل كان يضحك, he used to laugh a lot. كان يقول والله كنا قبل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصنع أحدنا الصنم من العجوة. From dates. He says, Subhanallah, how stupid that we were. He said, we used to make idols from dates. من التم. فإذا جاء أحدنا أكل. If we get hungry, we would eat it. فقال, Subhanallah, how we didn't think about that? We eat what we create, and then when we create it, we worship it. كان يقول, كنا نعبد هذا الأصنام. فأتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سراجا منيرا صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned these two names, these two descriptions في القرآن. قال وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه, that he is a caller to Allah. وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه, that he calls people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the will of Allah, by the order of Allah. وسراجا منيرا صلى الله عليه وسلم. يبقى السراج المنير, a name, اسم ولا صفة or attribute? Attribute of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His name is not Siraj Munir. Okay? This is one of the attributes of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. كَذَا بِهِ الْمُزَّمِّلَ الْمُدَّثِّرَ وَدَاعِيًا لِلَّهِ وَالْمُذَكِّرَ كَذَا بِهِ الْمُزَّمِّلَ الْمُدَّثِّرَ وَدَاعِيًا لِلَّهِ وَالْمُذَكِّرَ Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, المزمل. المزمل هو الذي يغطى بثوب فوق ثوب. The one that you wear a garment over, the one that he wears a garment over another garment. And the story behind that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, when first Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent Jibreel to him, لما أتى جبريل في الحديث, حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها, في صحيح البخاري حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها, the first حديث in صحيح البخاري, second حديث in صحيح البخاري, تقول لما نزل الوحي على النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم والقصة المعروفة, the story that we all know that الوحي was revealed, قال اقرأ, قال ما أنا بقارئ, فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ارتعب, he got scared, first time seeing the angel, and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saw him in his actual form, في صورته الحقيقية. فجبريل كان جناحي تسد الايش, تسد الافاق, تسد السماء, just the wings of جبريل would block the entire sky, so رسول الله got scared, فجاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يرتعب, he was shaking, فقال زملوني زملوني, he said put another garment on me, I feel cold. فقالت خديجة رضي الله عنها, she was surprised, what happened, فقال لها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that this thing came to me, he didn't know, فقال اقرأ, فقلت ما أنا بقارئ, فقال اقرأ, قلت ما أنا قلت ماذا أقرأ, قال اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق, خلق الإنسان من علم, اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. في هنا فائدة, that Allah told Rasulullah to read, correct, and then the fourth ayah he said الذي علم بالقلم, so how do we actually study 100% correct, كيف الإنسان يذاكر 100% صحيح, you read and write, that's why I told you before, if you want to have this knowledge stick here, it's good that you listen, and at the same time if you write notes it'll be better for you, of course there's not an order to write now, but I'm saying anywhere, so they tell you take notes after me, because when you go home and review you need that qalam, whatever you wrote it will stay here because you wrote it with your own hand, تمام. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رجع فقال زملوني زملوني, لذلك سمي المزمل, so المزمل هو الذي يغطى بثوب فوق ثوبه, the one who wears a garment over another garment because you feel cold, you're shaking, so he said you know what, this is maybe this thawb is not good enough, let me get another one, have double thawb. ومدثر, المدثر هو الذي يلف في ثوبه, the difference between المزمل المدثر, المدثر is the one who gets wrapped in a blanket or another garment, gets wrapped, not wear it. المزمل, when first Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم came to خديجة, قال زملوني, I need another thawb because I feel cold. The second, when he came to خديجة ونزل عليه جبريل المرة الثانية, the second time, it was even harder than the first time. فقال دثروني, يعني ضعوا علي الثياب ثم يلف بالثوب. He gets wrapped in the thawb or the blanket out of, because he was feeling so cold and he was shaking. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is how he was all the time when Jibreel would come down to him for revelation. صلى الله عليه وسلم. That one of the صحابي قال, في مرة جلست بجوار النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, فنزل عليه جبريل بالقرآن. قال, فوضع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يده على فخذي, فكانت والله أثقل علي من جبل أحد. هذا البروفيس سلم said one time, جلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was sitting down and صحابي was next to him. صحابي قال, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, جبريل came to reveal the Quran on him, so رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم had his hand on my lap. What do we take from this hadith? That the lab is not part of the awra, the major awra. And this could be good evidence for you to use if we consider it not to be a major awra. Because the major awra is the private part. But in the salah, we have to cover which awra? The major and the minor. هذا يسمى من الايه? From the minor awra. So if we're sitting among each other now, only men, okay? And we're wearing shorts that's not covering our knees. Or above, a little bit above our knee. Don't say this, brother, please hide your awra. He's not in salah. This is the argument that if he was part of the awra, Rasulullah would not have put his hand on it. And we have another hadith that Rasulullah himself was sitting down and his thawb was all the way to his knees, and some narration قالت لإيه لفخذيه. لما دخل أبو بكر and he talked to him and he left, وجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما هو, ثم دخل عمر رضي الله عنه, he talked to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he left, فخرج. فلما دخل عثمان استأذن, before عثمان came in, what did he do? جلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم سوى ثوبه. He fixed his clothes. And then Uthman came. He talked to Rasulullah. Then he left. فقالت عائشة يا رسول الله دخل أبو بكر وعمر وأنت على حالتك. He's still the same way when Abu Bakr and Umar came. لماذا لما دخل عثمان أو استأذن عثمان سويت ثوبك؟ فقال يا عائشة أفلا أستحي من رجل تستحي منه الملائكة. He said, how can't I be embarrassed from or shy from a man whom the angels themselves are shy and embarrassed from him? عثمان رضي الله عنه. So this is a proof just for the hour part. But in the salah, you have to cover below your knees, that your knees should not be shown. So after the knees is okay to pray with, but after the knees, this is a problem. كثير من الإخوة, this is only with the brother. The sisters, they have to cover everything. لابد تغطية المرأة كلها في الصلاة. But for us, except the face and the hand, with the argument, we're not going to go into that. ماشي. Except the face and the hand for now. Oh, صحيح, صحيح. It has argument. بس خلينا في الموضوع. بس the brothers, they pray with shorts. صح؟ كثير من الإخوة يصلون بالإيه؟ بالشورت هذا. The problem, the shorts could be below the knees. قد يكون تحت الركب. Okay. لكن لما يركع أو يسجد, what happened? When he makes ركوع and سجود, the shorts will pull up and then his knees will show. Salah is invalid. Because he haven't covered, Salah تكون غير صحيح. يبقى لابد أن الشورت يكون مغطي الركبة أثناء الصلاة. That the shorts has to cover the knees during the salah, not outside salah. Because outside salah, a lot of brothers, they sag. Huh? You know what's sagging, huh? Nobody, عارفين الساجن? الساجن اللي هو تنزيل البنطلون هذا لغاية النص حتى عزكم الله يظهر مؤخرة أو يعني he's buying new shorts maybe. What is Jordans or something? He want to show it to everybody. Anyway, هذا Legos, ينزل البنطال إلى هذه أصبحت الآن very famous back home now. They are copying here and they're sagging their shorts and their pants that their underwear has to show. That's the part of it. Why is that? Allah alam. If they know the reason why people start sagging, then they'll stop doing it. Like they don't know. المهم. طيب, if the brother is doing that and his shorts is actually covering his knees, يغطي الركب. During the salah, well, the other part is going to show. فلو غطى the top, the bottom is going to show. فغطى فهذا لابد ان الشورت ان يكون مغطي للركبتين اثناء الصلاه. The shorts must cover the knees during the salah or else the salah will be invalid. نعم.
Is there a difference of opinion on the top or the bottom? Because I heard from somewhere that
Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الركبه, the knees. So the knees has to be covered. The entire knees. The part about the difference في the belly, السرة, من السرة, starting from the belly to the knees. So they took from that, is it above the belly or at the belly or below the belly? That's the where the difference came from. لكن with the knees, Rasulullah said to the knees, that means to cover the knees. تمام? Understand that? Same thing with the thobe. If you have a short thobe, same thing. It has to cover also the knees. طيب. كذا به المزمل المدثر وداعيا لله والمذكر داعيا إلى الله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو أعظم داعية عرفته الأرض. The best person to call to Allah سبحانه وتعالى was رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why they call him الداعية. الداعية is someone who calls people to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وكان من أعظم الدعاء أو أعظم الدعاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتكلم بالكلام البسيط تكتب الآن فيه الكتب. The Prophet would talk with few words. The ulama after that had to write books about these words. Like the hadith that says لا ضرر ولا ضرار. لا ضرر ولا ضرار. How many words? No harm and you shouldn't cause harm. So no harm, no causing harm. كم كلمة؟ نقول لا ضرر ولا ضرار. Consider four. خليهم four. نديهم two extra. لا. Consider that. Four words. تمام؟ لو جئنا نحن نشرح هذا الكلام كم نحتاج من ورق؟ How many papers do you need to explain this? And the maximum we'll get to maybe two pages. Okay. No harm. There's a scholar, he wrote a book. كتب كتاب على هذا الحديث 300 صفحة. 300 pages. And all Rasulullah had to do is say لا ضرر ولا ضرار. أصفق. لذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أعظم داعي. He knew everyone's situation. Okay, he needs this advice, I give it to him. لما جاء الرجل قال يا رسول الله أوصني. قال رسول الله give me advice. أوصني. فقال له النبي إيه؟ لا تغضب. Don't be angry. فقال الرجل يا رسول الله أوصني. قال لا تغضب. فقال في الثالثة يا رسول الله أوصني. قال لا تغضب. That's all he said. He didn't give him a lecture. He didn't say, well, you don't look good today. Why are you asking questions? What advice do you want? He didn't say all of that. قال يا رسول قال أوصني. Advise me. He said, don't be angry. فقال الرجل فنظرت في الغضب فوجدته ملاك الشر كله. He said, I look back to anger. See what? Why? He said, don't get angry. Then he said, I found that anger is a cause of every problem. So Rasulullah's advice was wider than what he asked. He wanted an advice because that's why he said, give me more. أنا جئت أسألك من مكان بعيد أقول لا تغضب بس. If Rasulullah, you want to talk to Rasulullah, and Rasulullah tell you, خلاص أحمد جزاك الله لا تغضب. At least كان يحب أنه يتكلم مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. لكن النبي وكان في الرواية الأخرى في رواية أحمد أن الرجل هو من؟ من الرجل في هذا الحديث؟ Who's the man in this hadith that Rasulullah told him don't be angry? Who knows? Very famous Sahabi was one of the people who gets angry very fast. كان يغضب بسرعة. طيب لا جاء له جاء I'll give you a hint. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا الرجل هذا الصحابي قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله أمرني. فقال إنك رجل ضعيف ونحن لا نعطي الإمارة من سأله. ها أبو ذر رضي الله أبو ذر رضي الله عنه أبو ذر he said إنك رجل ضعيف it doesn't mean that you're weak. رسول الله meant when he asked رسول الله he said يا رسول الله I want to be a leader. I want to lead like everybody. You send عمر to be a leader there, you send عثمان to be a leader here. I want to lead too. قال the hadith says you're weak. Doesn't mean that he's weak as a, the form of a human, but it means that he gets angry so fast. And Rasulullah said, that anger cannot be in a leader. Leader has to be wise because he has to deal with everybody. Tamam? Hakim has to deal with people who are smart, people who are dumb, people who understand, people who don't understand, rich and poor. So if he's going to get angry, لذلك من هم يعني في صفة؟ أولا هي صفة رحمة. وتعلمك الصبر. لذلك أمر الله عز وجل كل نبي بالعمل فيها اللي هي رعي الإيش؟ الغنم. Shepherd is the one who has patience, is very wise, because the sheep or the goats or the lambs, what happened? They don't walk together. هذا الغنم تذهب هكذا وهذا الغنم تذهب هكذا. So if he's angry, what would he do? If this sheep pisses him off, he'll take it and kill it. خلاص, just slaughter it. After one month, ما الذي يحدث؟ يقول الرجل ولا عنده حتى دجاجة. لذلك أمر الله عز وجل الأنبياء بتعلم هذه بالعمل في هذه الوظيفة. This job, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, when they told him, يا رسول الله أرعيت الغنم؟ قال ما من نبي إلا ورعى الغنم. تعلم الصبر, gives you patience. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان أفضل داعية. Another, this is just too short. A man came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this happened actually in real life. قال له شاب, youth, young man. فقال يا رسول الله إذن لي بالزنا. He said, يا رسول الله, give me a permission to practice adultery, fornication. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أترضاه لأمك؟ قال لا. He said, would you like that to happen to your mother? قال لا. قال أترضاه لأختك؟ said, would you like that to happen to your sister? قال لا. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كذلك الناس لا يرضونه لأمهاتهم وأخواتهم. People, they do the same thing. They don't like that to happen to their mother or to their sisters. ثم مسح النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wiped on his chest. فمسح النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على صدره. Then the man said, I left with no desire. خلاص. Left. فذهبت الشهوة من قلبه. كان في شيخ من الشيوخ يعني أراد أن يجرب هذا الحديث. He wanted to actually practice this hadith here. فجاء الرجل شاب من الشباب قال يا شيخ إذن لي بالزنا. I want to practice it all here in America. Okay, he wanted to apply the same hadith. See the wisdom of Rasulullah. فقال the sheikh asked, قال أترضاه لأختك؟ So what? She has a boyfriend. قال الشيخ oh okay. We can keep going. He said already so what. قال do you like that for your sister? He said so what. She already have a boyfriend. Like what's the big deal? So the sheikh said okay. I cannot use this hadith. I need to find something else. هذا الحكمة في دعوة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كل إنسان يعطيه الخبر بما يناسبه. تذكرون حديث في الطهارة when the man asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا رسول الله أنا توضأ من ماء البحر. تكلمنا عن هذا في الدعوة. أنا توضأ من ماء البحر. Can we make wudu from the water of the sea water? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said yes. The water of the sea is pure. الحل ميتته and the dead animal of the sea is also halal for you to eat. But the man only asked for the water. This is out of the wisdom of Rasulullah sallam as a da'iyah. Nowadays, the problem عندنا دعاء two types. Ones who do not understand what they're saying, which is a big problem. هذا أنواع الدعاء. A man who doesn't know what he's talking about. تمام؟ So he doesn't prepare. لا يحضر مثلا. He goes on the minbar, يقول لك الله يفتح علينا إن شاء الله ونتكلم. Then he starts talking. فتجده يأتي بكلمة من الشرق وكلمة من الغرب. At the end of the khutbah, he asks your brother, say, جزاك الله خير brother Khalid. What was the khutbah about? فلك والله man, if you know, let me know. هذا this is a type. The second type is a group who give da'wah, but they do not give it in the right place at the right time. And this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu and the wisdom of Rasulullah sallallahu to give the right talk at the right time. هذا الإنسان يغضب, he advised him لا تغضب. هذا الإنسان he wants another advice. Rasulullah sallallahu knows that he doesn't need the advice لا تغضب. He needs another advice, then he will give it to him. Third man, no, هذا يحتاج إلى أن يتعلم الدين, then you teach him Islam. Other people, no, you tell them more to do extra ibadah because they already got the basics. And this is the wisdom of the da'iyah. Who is he talking to? The people. The listeners is very important. Okay? And at the same time, the topic that you choose is very important. If you want, like for example, if we talk, لو تكلمنا ساعة, and we talked about the difference between the scholar's opinion on eating camel's meat. And then we get all the opinions and the evidence. And let's talk about it for maybe 2 hours. What happened? After people leave here, like, oh, why is the sheikh talking about camels? I haven't even seen camel myself with my own eyes. Maybe. Now I'm going to eat it. So do we need that? Not really. We just need to know basic information about it. Then we keep going. فلا توقف مع أشياء كثير. لذلك بعضهم يقول, let's go out of the restroom in fiqh. Every sheikh who talks about tahar, restroom. How do you use hammam? How do you use restroom? How do you use the... Let's talk about zakah and siyam and hajj and umrah and ibadat and muamalat and dealing and buying and selling. Keep going. هذا من from the wisdom of the da'wah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. وداعياً لله والمذكرة. المذكر is the one who remind people. الذي يذكر الناس بالله عز وجل. يذكر الناس بتوحيد الله عز وجل. يأمر الناس ويذكرهم ويأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ورحمة ونعمة وهادي وغيرها تجل عن تحدادي ورحمة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أزوسات الله رحم به البشر ببعثته صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمت البشر من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم all of mankind gained some of Rasulullah's mercy. Kuffar who lived at Mecca, what happened? Allah didn't send, لم ينزل الله عز وجل عليهم عذابا من السماء فيأخذهم جميعا لأن كان فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah didn't send them a punishment to destroy all of them because Rasulullah was among them. So they got some of the mercy of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The hypocrites, المنافقون, what happened to them? مجرد أن قالوا لا إله إلا الله عصموا دماءهم أموالهم وأعراضهم. As soon as they said La ilaha illallah, they protected their honors, their wealth, their family, and their souls. Even though they are منافقون, hypocrites. خلاص, just saying La ilaha illallah. لما جاء عمر فقال يا رسول الله إنه منافق, he's a hypocrite. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, we're not ordered. أن الله عز وجل لم يبعثنا ميسرين ولم يبعثنا معسرين. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى didn't, Allah سبحانه وتعالى send us to make things easy on people, not hard on them. And we were not allowed, to check their hearts. We can't check people's hearts. So as soon as someone called La ilaha illallah, خلاص. Shaykh, but he doesn't come to the masjid. Don't worry about that. Is he a Muslim? Yes. Disobedient, that's something else. So what's our job? Advice, but not judge people. تمام؟ فهذه رحمة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعمة. هي نعم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نعمة من أعظم نعم الله عز وجل على العباد. It's نعمة is a blessing of Allah. So this is an attribute of Rasulullah that Allah sent him as blessing for us. If you follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, يكون النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لك نعمة. نعمة is a gift. It's actually a gift that someone gave it to you. What would you do with that gift? لو أن إنسان تحبه كثيرا وأعطاك هدية, ماذا تصنع بهذه الهدية؟ ها؟ What would you do? He's gonna put it in a museum. ما شاء الله. Keep it, صح. Keep it somewhere safe, clean. You don't like anyone to touch it. Or else you're gonna take it and throw it away. That means you dislike the person. So Allah, that we love more than anything on earth, gave us Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a gift. So our job is to take care of this gift. How? بِاتِّبَاعِ سُنَّتِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. To follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing? By thanking Allah for Rasulullah every day in our life. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من صلى علي صلاة صلى الله بها عليه عشر. That's the least that you could do. هذا من أقل شكر نعم الله عز وجل عليه في النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن تصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قل اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. هذا how long can it take you? كم تأخذك هذا الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ دقيقة, دقيقتين, ثلاث, أربع, خمس. الله forgive your sins, يغفر الله لك الذنوب. الله will raise your ranks. الله will reward you. 10 times, if you do it once, Allah give it to you. 10, if you do it 10, Allah 100 multiply. Then if you do it 100, it's 1,000. And then we don't do it. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نعمة. وهاديا, the one who guide. And here, الهداية تنقسم إلى قسمين. هداية تبيين وإرشاد, وهداية توفيق. هدايتان, الهداية هداية توفيق وهداية تبيين وإرشاد. There are two types of guidance. توفيق is the guidance that is from Allah. تبيين is the guidance by noticing. Meaning, رسول الله was sent to guide us. True or false? True? So how come we have people who are non-Muslim? نقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله هدايته, هي هداية إيش؟ تبيين وإرشاد, يعني يبين للناس طريق الهداية. لكن التوفيق من من؟ من الله. So guidance by showing, by example, by showing, by leading the way is from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So رسول الله's job هي إيش؟ هي هداية التبيين والإرشاد, to show people the way. That's it, that's all رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم had to do. Guide him. Guide him means to tell him, you know, this is Allah's path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول افعل, Allah يقول لا تفعل. If you follow this, you will enter paradise. If you don't follow this, you will enter hellfire. That's guidance of Rasulullah. He's guiding us, that he's leading us to the guidance, which comes from Allah. هداية التوفيق. The true guidance, the real guidance is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنك لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء. طيب, how is this ayah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم, truly you guide people to the straight path, and then we have an ayah that says you do not guide whom you love, Allah guides whom he wants. So does Rasulullah guide or he doesn't? Now for Rasulullah leads to guidance, shows the way to guidance. يبين يرشد الناس, هذا طريق الله عز وجل, هذه هداية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, أن يرشدك أين الطريق, يبين لك الطريق. لكن هداية التوفيق, the real guidance that you are guided is through Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما نزلت هذه الآية كانت في عمه أبي طالب. Abu Talib was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's uncle, and he was the most beloved person to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after Khadija of their time. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحبه, وهو دافع عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم السنين. Defended, he fought for Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for years. فلما كان عمه على فراش الموت قال يا عم قل لا إله إلا الله كلمة أشفع لك بها عند ربي يوم القيامة. He told his uncle, say one word, just one word, so I could intercede for you in the day of judgment. Just one word that I want from you. لا إله إلا الله. فكان بجواره أبو جهل وعتبة وربيع and others. Around him was his companions. أبو جهل, ربيع, those are the disbelievers. فقالوا أتترك دين أبائك وأجدادك, تترك دين عبد المطلب, you want to leave the religion of your father. And to the Arab this was shame, you leave the religion of your father and your grandfather and your family, so this is a form of shame. So they remind him of that. They said, ah, don't say it, you're good, you're in the religion of your father, what else do you want? وهذا دائما نذكر به بالصحبة الصالحة والصحبة السيئة. الصحبة الصالحة تأخذ بيدك إلى الله, والصحبة السيئة تأخذ بيدك عن الله. Good companion, good friends will take your hands to Allah. Bad companions will take your hands away from Allah. They'll take you away from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. لذلك لما أبو طالب, these bad companions reminded him and told him, don't leave your religion for father, لا تترك دينك. ماذا قال؟ قال أموت على ديني عبد المطلب, I will die on the religion of عبد المطلب. That's a disbeliever. رسول الله when he asked, well, he is the least who's getting punished in the hereafter. أقل من يعذب يوم القيامة أبو طالب, توضع في تحت قدميه جمرتان من النار فيغلي منهما دماغه. رب سلمه. He's the least that he will stand on two pieces of fire, rocks that is from hellfire, he will stand on them, that's all he's gonna do, stand on them, his entire body to his head will be boiling. So this is the least in hellfire. May Allah save all of us from hellfire. صلى الله ينجينا من النار ومن عذابه ويرضى عنا برضاه. The طيب, هذا, this is an example. سورة الكهف. الله سبحانه وتعالى قال سيقولون ثلاثة ورابعهم كلبه, صح؟ ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم رجما بالغيب, ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم. So this is about the people of the cave. Allah said people will claim that they are three and their dog is four, or they are five and their dog is number six, or they are seven and their dog with them will be eight together. Look at this. Abu Talib was laying down, around him was who? Bad companions. What happened to Abu Talib? دخل النار. طيب, this dog, هذا الكلب, لما اتبع الصالحين كان معهم في القرآن. Just that dog was around righteous people. Allah mentioned the dog in the Quran. So if you imagine if we around good people, what would happen to us? كلب كلب يذكره الله في الكتاب إلى يوم القيامة. A dog that is mentioned in the Quran till the day of judgment. A dog that we say, oh come on man, a dog. لكنه كلب. ذكر مع من؟ مع الصالحون. لماذا؟ لأنه اتبعهم. Because the dog followed the righteous people, the dog was mentioned with them in the Quran until the day of judgment. So imagine if we follow righteous people, if we sit with them. وهذا من الآيات العجيبة جدا. لذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء. The example of a good companion and a bad companion is like حامل المسك ونافخ الكير. It's like the example of a person who carries perfume and a person who works with fire. فحامل المسك إما أن تشم منه رائحة طيبة رائحة ذكية أو تنتفع بشيء منه. The one who carries perfume, if you are around him, what happened? If you have a friend who sells perfume, يعني مثلا as soon as you see you, جزاك الله خير تفضل صح؟ He will see you, he give you some perfume, so you benefit from him. Let's say he doesn't give you perfume, what happened? At least you smell good. He smells good, so you smell the good from him. إما أن تشم منه رائحة طيبة أو إيه؟ أن تنتفع به. طيب نافخ الكير. Person who works with fire and he burns things and connect irons together and so on. What would he? Person who blow in fire. إما أن تشم منه رائحة سيئة أو أن يحرق ثوبك. It's either if you're close to him, he will burn your clothes. If you're standing there looking at him, شوف ماذا يصنع. Your clothes might get burned. Let's say you're saved. Alhamdulillah, he didn't burn you. The smell is bad. And this is هذا مثال الجليس الصالح. This is the example of a good companion and a bad friend. A good companion that he will tell you, جزاك الله خير, brother, it's time for Salat al-Asr. Then he would leave. Then you remember Salat al-Asr. Another companion will like, let's see what's on TV. I call Salat time. I'm like, oh, the Sheikh, don't worry. His iqamah is 5 o'clock. It's still 4:30. Then you start watching TV. After half an hour, the movie gets excited. Then you tell him, brother, jazakallah khair, as-salat. Five minutes. It's going to finish right now. By the time the movie is finished, what time is it? Maghrib time. You go like, oh, we miss Asr, subhanallah. Khalas, we can't do Asr because Maghrib is coming. What about Maghrib? Let me take you to dinner. Then he'll invite you. You miss Maghrib. It's Isha time. You go like, oh, khalas, man. You miss Asr, Maghrib. Now you're going to pray Isha? Forget it. لكن الجليس الصالح, what would he do? Let's go right now. وقت الصلاة. He will wake you up for Fajr. He will call you at Fajr time. He'll like, are you awake? Yes, alhamdulillah. A bad companion, he'll like, just sleep, man. Turn the alarm off, man. I can't sleep. That's the difference. لذلك يختار الإنسان رجلا صالح إذا رآه ذكره بالله عز وجل. You take a friend that if you look at, you remember Allah. Do you have a friend like that? Inshallah, I'll ask Allah to give you one. You should look for someone like that. As soon as you see him, أول ما تشوف بقى تقول لا إله إلا الله سبحان الله. Some of us, as soon as we see them, نقول إيه؟ أعوذ بالله استغفر الله. صح؟ هذا كثير. Why? The problem is him. It's not you. Sometimes. لا هذا لذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم would guide you to the straight path of Allah. لذلك نقول كل يوم 17 مرة سورة الفاتحة اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. How come we're not guided? الحمد لله نحن هدينا إلى الصراط باتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم باتباع هذا الدين. لكن نقول اهدنا أي ثبتنا. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى make us firm on the path of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. لأنه هذا طريق والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم draw a line and then lines around it. فقال this is the straight path of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. هذا طريق الله عز وجل ومن بينه أو على حافته شياطين كل يدعو إلى طريق وإلى سبيل. says there's a shayateen at the road. You're walking to Allah, you're going toward Allah, toward paradise, and you have the shayateen pulling you away. If you turn around and listen to them, what happened? You'll be led with them. So we ask Allah for the guidance. We are already guided, but we ask Allah to stay firm on this guidance. لِيَ هِدَيَةَ التَّوْفِيقِ تَكُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. نعم يقول وهادياً وغيرها تجل عن تعدادي. أي أن فيه هناك أسماء كثيرة وصفات كثيرة تجل عن تعداد, أي أنه لم يعدوه هنا لأنها كثيرة جدا لا يتسع المقام يعني لذكرها. What are some names of Rasulullah other than what we mentioned? الصادق الأمين. الصادق الأمين, the truthful and the trust, the trustworthy or the trusted one, or the trustful, if we could say that. I don't know if we could add full to trustful. Yeah, trustful you could say. طيب, the truthful is the one who never lie. The trusted one, or the trustful, is the one whom people trusted him with. And this was given to him by who? The kuffar. And the best description or attribute to be given is by your enemy. أفضل صفة يعطاها الإنسان وما شهد به الأعداء. If these people say about you, they hate you so much, but they say, Muhammad, we know, I hate him, I don't like to work with him, but he never lies. That's the best attribute. That's why we have to show that as our deen in front of everybody. When you show that you are Muslim, be proud of it. تقول هذا هو. When they ask you, لماذا تفعل كذا, قل هذا الإسلام. So if they witness, قول سبحان الله, أنا اشتغلت مع إنسان مسلم لا يكذب, إنسان مسلم لا يغش, إنسان مسلم من أفضل من الناس الذين عملتهم. Said the best man that I was with is a Muslim. The one that I trust the most is a Muslim. I work with someone and I never seen anyone who's truthful like him is a Muslim. Nowadays the problem is, like somebody was telling me, a guy, قال ركبت سيارة, when he first came to the United States, the police stopped him on the freeway. فأوقفوا. يعني he was calling on the phone. قال, because I was going from a lane to another, okay, while driving. So the police was after him. فأوقفوا البوليس. قال, sir, do you drink? Are you drunk? Why are you driving like that? هل تشرب الخمر؟ فقال أخ, أنا اسمي محمد. And here's my ID. The police officer took ID. فقال محمد, oh, أعرف أن المسلمين لا يشربون الخمر. خلاص, you could go. I know. قال سبحان الله. 10 years after, same incident, نفس القصة. أوقفوا الشرطي. فقال, what happened, sir? You drunk? قال اسمي محمد. قال so what? I just got Muhammad yesterday from a club. I just got Muhammad yesterday pulled over because he was smoking. I just got Muhammad pulled over. قال سبحان الله. قال كم محمد أخذ من البارات, كم محمد يشرب الخمر, كم بعد 10 سنوات. قال سوى اسمك محمد, وأنا I just arrested them yesterday. هذا look at the example. Who's showing Islam? This is the problem. We are the one, we are the picture of Islam. So that's why we must show the best of who we are by following our religion and showing our religion. We're not inventing something new. This is what the deen says. You're not doing extra thing. You're not saying, I'm better than him because I have this idea. Be better, be good to people, therefore they would respect you. This is what your deen tells you. Whether you like it or not, you have to be good to Muslims and to non-Muslims. طيب الصادق الأمين الشافع والمشفع, the one who intercede for us in the day of judgment. في الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يشفع. And how do we get the شفاعة؟ كيف نأتي يعني كيف يستحق المرء منا شفاعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ How do we, very easy way, we could get the intercession of رسول الله. No. لا. أيوة. The دعاء after أذان. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة الصلاة القائمة آتي محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة عث اللهم مقام المحمود الذي وعدته. If we say that, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, if you ask Allah, لو سألتم الله لي الوسيلة لحلت لكم الشفاعة. لو سألتم الله لي الوسيلة. If you ask Allah for this place, الوسيلة is the high place, وأعلى مكان في الجنة. قال لو سألتم الله لي الوسيلة لحلت لكم الشفاعة. Then you will have my intercession in the day of judgment. Very easy way. Some of us, we even say it without even noticing the words. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة تمام صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then, yeah, what happened? What did you say? Oh, I repeated after the adhan. Then, alhamdulillah, I did the اللهم رب هذه الدعوة. Understand the wording so you know what you're saying. You know what you're saying, that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a wasila, the highest place in paradise, to be for Rasulullah, then you will have the intercession of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَقُولُ وَقَدْ وَعَى إِبْنُ الْعَرَبِيِّ سَبْعَةٌ مِنْ بَعْدِ سِتِّينَ وَقِيلَ تِسْعَةٌ. Ibn al-Arabi, هو الإمام المالكي, ليس ابن العربي الصوف, لا, الإمام المالكي هو له شرح عارضة الأحوذي في شرح سنن الترمذي رحمه الله. He counted 67 names. ذكر سبعة أو قال أو قيل تسعة, 67 or 69 names of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. من بعد تسعين ولابن دحيتي الفحص يوفيها 300. ابن دحية was one of the scholars. لما ابن دحية أبو الخطاب عمر بن حسن الداني was from an Andalus, and he counted the names of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to be 300 names. Not only 67. قال وكونها ألفا ففي العارضة ذكرها عن بعض ذي الصوفية. Some of the Sufis, they even counted the names of Rasulullah to be 1,000. قالوا if Allah has 99 names, تمام, then Rasulullah has 99 names. And then they started adding the attributes and the names of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What we have is good enough for the names of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب, the نسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the lineage and family of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. يقول المصنف رحمه الله وهو أي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is ابن عبد الله عبد المطلب أبوه وهو شيبة الحمد نسب. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اسمه, his name is محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. محمد ابن عبد الله. عبد الله is his father's name. And his father died before Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم's birth. مات قبل ولادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على الصحيح. Some people, في بعض الأقوال تقول أنه مات بعد سنتين من ولادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لكن الصحيح أنه مات قبل ولادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That he passed away, he died, his father عبد الله, before the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away. And he was traveling. And Abdullah has a story that Rasulullah's grandfather Abdul Muttalib نذر لله نذر أنه لو رزق بعشرة من الأولاد يذبح أحده. He said, والله, if Allah gives me 10 children, 10 boys, I will slaughter one of them for the sake of Allah. طبعا هذا النذر, النذر is a promise, from you to Allah that you do something if Allah does something for you. تمام؟ النبي يقول في الحديث النذر لا يأتي بخير. النذر لا يأتي بخير. That a promise that you make will never bring good to you. Because you could say, Ya Allah, if I get A in the test, inshallah in the final, if I get A, I'll slaughter a cow and feed the entire masjid. Then you get A plus. Then you look in your pockets, I don't have the price for the cow. So you ask people to help you, like nobody's going to help you. What happened? You're stuck with the promise. You have to do it. Or the kafara is be to fast, to feed, or to give sadaqah or so on. But you have to do it. You have to do the nadr as you said. So instead, if you want to do your promise, لو أردت أن تنذر تقول اللهم إني أنذر إليك أن أفعل خيرا إن حدث لي كذا وكذا. You say, Allah, I promise to do something good if I get an A in the test. So something good means what? Oh, anything. Giving charity is something good. Feeding people is something good. Praying in the masjid is something good. Anything. But if you limit yourself to a promise, then you have to do it. That's why be careful, because before you say, Ya Allah, if just this happened, I would do this. As soon as you say, like you say, I will slaughter a goat. A goat is how much now when you buy a goat? $200? $200, say. Can you say, I'm going to slaughter a cow because it's more expensive, it's better? You have to slaughter a goat. Can it be a lamb? No, because you said a goat. So which one is better? To say, I will slaughter something for the sake of Allah? Afdal. Then, or I'll slaughter a goat? No, slaughter something for the sake of Allah. Because it could be a chicken. Okay, I could give you a chicken leg and say, you know what, I slaughter a chicken here, that's my promise. But if you limit yourself, لِلنَّذْرِ لِذَلِكَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالْ النَّذْرُ لَا يَأْتِي بِخَيْرٍ.
So if you say, if you make the promise that you will slaughter it, does that mean you can do it with your own hand also?
No, if you didn't promise that, then it's okay. Slaughter mean I would do it.
Yeah.
I could pay someone to do it, and the meaning of that. But if you say, I'll slaughter it with my own hand just for you, Allah, then you have to do that. So don't, see a lot of people, they do that. And don't put a condition for Allah. Learn this. Don't do that. Don't tell, Ya Allah, you give me this, I give you this. Or I do this. Don't do that. Be generous. Like, you know, the man, they all say the story. Okay, the man said, if Allah gives me a child, no, he had a child. فقال, لو أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يشفي لي هذا الولد, أصوم لله ثلاث أيام. تمام؟ He said, والله, if Allah give me a child, I'll fast for Allah 3 days for the sake of Allah. So Allah, if he, Allah cures my child. فالله شفى الله له الولد. قال الحمد لله, صام ثلاث أيام. He fasted 3 days. After 1 month, the kid died. قال, okay. إن شاء الله I'll subtract it from Ramadan. The 3 days that I fasted. You put condition for Allah. You're playing around. Say, Ya Allah, I'll do something good. خلاص, over. But don't put a condition. Don't say, Allah, if you don't do this to me, I won't do this. If I do, what if Allah doesn't give it to you because you know it's better for you? Like, بعض الناس يسأل يقول يا الله أعطني ولد. He say, Ya Allah, give me a boy. Then after 10 years, Allah will give him a boy. After the boy grows and he's now 15, يقول, يا الله, yes, take him. I don't even want to see his face again. صح لا؟ كثير من الناس يفعل ذلك. بعد أن يرزق الله سبحانه وتعالى يكون الولد يعني شيطان, استغفر الله, مش شيطان, يعني قريب من الشيطان, يقول يعني يا ليتني لم أرزق بهذا الولد. صح ولا لا؟ فالله سبحانه وتعالى knows what's better for you. So leave it to Allah, leave it to Allah and Allah will give you the best. So عبد المطلب anyway قال فالله give me 10 boys, I'll slaughter one for them. طبعا من نذر بسوء أو أن يعصي الله فلا يفعل. Someone, لما واحد يقول إيش تركي, ها, يقول أنا لو نجحت اليوم أشرب خمر أرتاح, أروح البار at night. If you give that promise that is haram, don't do it. Don't tell me, Sheikh, I made a promise already. If I get A in the final, I'll go to a nightclub. I can't. I already made that promise. Well, you and your promise, go to the nightclub, astaghfirullah. No. Promises, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَن نَذَرَ أَن يَعْصِ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَفْعَلْ. If someone promised to disobey Allah, then don't do it. Then say, I already said, خلاص. فقال, I'll slaughter one. So Allah أعطى 10 أولاد. وَكَانُوا يَقْتَرِعُونَ. Al-Qur'a is picking, they will have 10 sticks and small sticks. Like the meat skewer that you guys eat or the kebab, okay? And they'll have each person's name on it, and then they'll move it around in a cup, and then they'll pull one of them. The one that has the name, then it's the one who is picked. And this is a sunnah of some of the prophets, like Yunus. They did it when he was on the ship and he was thrown into the ocean. Every time they picked one, it would be Abdullah. And Abdullah was the most beloved among the children from Abdul Muttalib to Abdul Muttalib. So he didn't want to slaughter him. Very hard to slaughter your kid, actually. After that, he slaughtered 10 camels instead of Abdullah, just to save him. Somebody gave him that idea. And he slaughtered فَذَبَحْ عَشْرٌ مِنَ الْجِمَالِ. Then he slaughtered 100 later on, just to free his promise. They used to keep that, when they keep a promise, when they say a promise, they keep it. Even though they were disbelievers. Now you have someone who like, and there is no نذر in the ibadah that is obligatory. لا نذر في الفرائض. Meaning that, Ya Allah, inshallah, inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase me, my wealth, and gives me a good job that I apply for, I went to the interview, inshallah, if I get this job, I'll start praying the 5 times in the masjid. And then you're like, see, I'm doing the best that I can. What else do you want? 5 times in the masjid. Allah, this is obligatory. You have to do it whether Allah gives you the job or Allah takes the job away from you. Or someone says, I'm only fasting, inshallah, this Ramadan if I'm healthy all year. If I ever get sick during the year, I'm not fasting Ramadan. Forget it. What do you mean forget it? It's obligatory. You cannot say that. You have, when something that you must do, you have to do it. فَلِذَلِكَ لَمَّا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala freed him. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قَالَ أَنَا ابْنُ الذَّبِيحَيْنِ I am the son of the two who were slaughtered or were going to be slaughtered. Who? His father Abdullah, his actual father, and Ismail. Ismail. أَنَا ابْنُ الذَّبِيحَيْنِ أَيْ الذَّبِيحِ الْأَوَلِ إِسْمَعِيل عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ Remember, the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came Ismail. From his children, only Rasulullah is a prophet. From Ishaq, there's Yaqub. Then from Yaqub, everyone who was sent to Banu Israel, from that branch. The branch of Ismail, alayhi salam, in Tariq Ismail, only one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ أَنَا ابْنُ الذَّبِيحَيْنِ أَيْ ابْنُ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ and Ismail. Ismail is the same story when his father wanted to slaughter him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him by sending a goat from heaven and he slaughtered it instead of him. أبوه, that's his father. وهو شيبة الحمد نسب أو نسب. شيبة الحمد عبد المطلب. شيبة is the gray hair. والشيب الذي يكون في الشعر is the gray hair that you have those when you grow old, inshallah, or maybe you're young and you have gray hair because you have children or making you crazy or a. No, I won't say that. Okay. No, I can't. I know Turkey wants me to be in trouble. La Turkey, Allah yahdik. It's better to be saved than sorry. Yeah, inshallah, or may Allah bless you with a good wife, she wouldn't give you gray hair. Let's say it this way. Alhamdulillah, my wife don't give me gray hair. Alhamdulillah, Rabbani. May Allah bless her and bless her life and increase her, inshallah, in their reward. So if you have a wife or a children who gives you gray hair, I don't have gray hair. So you know, alhamdulillah, good children, good wife. If you have it, may Allah help you. Okay? But then sometimes, خلي بالك بس, the wife who gives you gray hair, sometimes they could be actually a blessing for you. صح? As soon as you enter the house, she starts screaming and talking. What would you do? تذكر الله. So it should make you remember Allah. Or if it gets to the maximum, you run away from the house. Then you start visiting your father who you haven't visited for a while. You visit your mother who you haven't visited for a while. So she's actually a benefit for you. As soon as she throws the food in your face, you say, Ya Allah, sabbir, may Allah give me some patience. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. So you remember Allah. So sometimes they have benefit also. But may Allah give everyone a good wife, inshallah. And make our wife good. That's the tutu. And make us good to our wife. Sometimes we want our rights, but we don't care about their rights. Okay? And we don't want to go into that. That's not our topic right now. Turkey is the problem. It's between me and you. After Salah, wait for me. I need to talk to you after Salah. I know you wanted to cause trouble. Alhamdulillah. Shaybat al-Hamd, he was called that because when he was born, Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of Rasulullah, he had a gray hair in his hair the time that he was born. So they gave him this nickname. And you know the nickname is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnah is to have a nickname. And if you have a child, you could be called after him. Like the Prophet, what was his nickname? Very famous. Abu Al-Qasim. Abu Al-Qasim. So because his son was Al-Qasim. So if you have a son, you call Abu Ahmed, Abu Muhammad, Abu Ali, so and so. Or you choose a kunya that is not your son. Qala abuhu Amr Hashim wal-jaddu Abdu Manaf ibn Qusayyin Zaydu. Abu, so his name is Muhammad. Ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Abdul Muttalib, Shaybatul Hamd, Ibn Amr, Ibn Hashim. ولقبه هاشم عمر هو هاشم نفسه. هاشم هو أول سمي هاشم لأنه أول من هشم الثريد لقومه. الثريد اللي هو الخبز مع الإيه؟ مع اللحم اللي هو الفتة يعني. So he was called Hashim because he actually was the first one to break the bread to pieces mix it with meat and offer it to the people, to his family and to the people who came from for pilgrimage. And he was like the one to invent this type of food. And now we have it.